Well, it's week three, a lot of great out-of-conference contests and some great in-conference contests as we get ready to go around the SWAC here on the Pregame Show. Let's start her off. It is a huge Thursday night matchup. It is the Alabama A&M Bulldogs visiting Daytona Beach to take on the Bethune-Cookman Wildcats. The Bulldogs come into this game 1-0 after defeating South Carolina State in week one. Bethune-Cookman 0-2. Two tough non-conference losses thus far on the season, but when we take a look at this early season SWAC East showdown, Aquil Glass and his bevy of receivers, Abdul Fatah Ibrahim, Adu Hilaire, Xavier Moore, they get ready to take on this historically tough Bethune-Cookman defense led by Ontario Johnson and Caleb Sutherland. Should be a great one from Daytona Beach. That game will be on ESPNU. It is a 6:30 kickoff. Let's head over to Texas where the Houston Baptist Huskies, 0-2, they visit the 1-1 Prairie View A&M Panthers. Let's take a look at the Panthers. They are led by quarterback Juwan Pass. Week one, he passed for over 300 yards against Texas Southern. But let's take a look on the defensive side of the ball. They are led by Treshad Smith and Jason Dumas. Panthers 1-1, trying to defend their home turf against the Houston Baptist Huskies, who are led by sophomore quarterback Blaze Benson and senior linebacker Brennan Young. They dropped their home opener to Northern Colorado. But in that game, Brennan Young, he had 11 tackles. Look for that name. That'll be a 6 p.m. kickoff from the Hill, also known as Prairie View A&M University. We stay in Texas. Let's travel up to East Texas to Nacogdoches, Texas, where it'll be the Mississippi Valley State Delta Devils. They come into this game 0-1. They take on the 1-1 WAC Conference foe, Stephen F. Austin Lumberjacks. We take a look at Mississippi Valley. They feature preseason All-SWAC selectees, defensive back Caleb Brunson, running back Caleb Johnson, and of course the big man, defensive lineman Jerry Gardner. Texas, we take a look at Stephen F. Austin. They fell short in their upset bid of Texas Tech as they fall short 28-22, but they are led by the quarterback wide receiver duo of Trey Self. Thus far, he's completed 67% of his passes, and Xavier Gibson, who's caught 16 passes for 206 yards and a touchdown. 6 p.m. kickoff from Nacogdoches, Texas, Mississippi Valley State, and Stephen F. Austin. Let's travel back across the SWAC, back over into Florida. It'll be the Florida A&M Rattlers as they take on the University of South Florida Bulls. FAMU coming to this game 1-1, coming off a big victory over Fort Valley State. South Florida 0-2 thus far on the season. Let's take a look at the Rattlers. They are led by Legacy Bowl selectee wide receiver Xavier Smith. On the defensive side of the ball, they are led by defensive tackle Deontay Williams. Huge game against Fort Valley State. He had 3 tackles for losses and 2 sacks in that game. UCF defensively, they're led by safety Vincent Davis, Dwayne Boyles, and Antonio Greer. That will be a 6 p.m. kickoff from Raymond James Stadium. That game can be seen on ESPN+. Let's take it back over to Texas. The Grambling State Tigers, 0-2 coming into this contest, visit University of Houston, who are 1-1. Grambling, they are led by their trio of receivers, Cash Foley, Donald Johnson, and Kobe Ross. They go up against a tough offensive squad in U of H. They are led by quarterback Clayton Toon, who's thrown for 236 yards thus far in the season, and Antonio McCaskill. He rushed for 3 touchdowns as the Cougars retain their Bayou Bucket with a huge 44-7 win over Rice last week. Let's take it up now to Arkansas. University of Arkansas Pine Bluff, they get back into the fray this week as they were off last week. They take on Central Arkansas, UAPB, 1-0 thus far on the season. Big, huge early season victory against Lane. Central Arkansas, 0-2 coming into this contest. Of course, UAPB, they are led by Skylar Perry, who leads the Golden Lions in passing and rushing in their season opening win versus Lane. When we take a look at the Central Arkansas Bears, 2 of Central Arkansas Bears were honored this past week by the A-Sun on Monday with weekly football honors. Sophomore defensive end Logan Jessup, he was named the A-Sun Defensive Player of the Week. And freshman running back Tristan Smith was named the A-Sun Freshman of the Week. Should be a tough one. Smith leads UCA's rushing attack. Last week he had 79 yards on 8 carries on an average of 9.9 yards per carry. It is the Bears' home opener. They kick this off at 6 p.m. Saturday when they welcome UAPB to First Security Field at Estes Stadium. Let's travel now down to Baton Rouge, Louisiana, as McNeese State 0-2. They visit the 1-1 Southern Jaguars. When we take a look at McNeese State, they are led by Cody Orgeron at quarterback. He's gone and set a McNeese State record for most consecutive pass attempts without throwing an interception, 159 straight. We take a look at the Southern Jaguars. They are coming off a huge 41-24 victory over Miles. In that game, Craig Nelson, 134 yards. Glendon, Bubba McDaniel, he also went 10 of 13 for 140 yards through the air. 6 p.m. kickoff from A.W. Mumford Stadium in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Let's travel over now to Alabama, Mobile, as the Alcorn State Braves, 1-1. They visit South Alabama, the Braves. Big win last week against Northwestern State. Felix Harper, he threw for over 200 yards. Juwan Taylor and Solomon Wise, they combined for over 17 tackles in that 13-10 over Northwestern State. South Alabama, from the Sun Belt Conference, they are 2-0, and they are led by quarterback Jake Bentley and running back Terrion Avery, who rushed for 82 yards in their huge win over Bowling Green last week. It'll be the Braves visiting South Alabama. That game is a 6 p.m. kickoff as well in Mobile. And finally, we finish up with Jackson State, your 2-0 Tigers. They take on the UL Monroe Warhawks, who are 0-1 thus far on the season. We have to start. SWAC Players of the Week, Shador Sanders, 30 of 40, 362 yards, and 3 touchdowns. 30 completions set a new Southern Heritage Classic record as he distributed the ball last week to a total of 9 different receivers in that huge win with Jackson State over Tennessee State. Not to be outdone on the defensive side of the ball, James Houston, 4.5 sacks last week. He also had 5 tackles for a loss, 10 tackles total. And, of course, the cherry on top of the sundae, Warren Newman, SWAC Player of the Week from the specialist standpoint. He had an 81-yard punt return, huge punt return in that game against Tennessee State. ULM, they are led by wide receiver Boogie Knight, the Akron transfer. He emerged as ULM's most productive offensive threat. He had 6 catches for 58 yards, but the Warhawks were limited to 87 yards on 63 plays and 12 first downs in that opening week loss to the University of Kentucky. It'll be a 7 p.m. kickoff from Monroe, Louisiana. Jackson State taking on the ULM Warhawks. And folks, that is week 3 around the SWAC. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe to the Pregame Show with Charles Bishop and Neely.